I'm back on Hey Ref. Here's another episode. This one is going to be pertaining to the essentials, things that we might throw in our bags of travel, especially during this preceded time or during any season. So this can help you or anybody out there that travels a lot, and it's definitely something that I travel with. So after you get a lovely negative test, y'all, you need to pack your stuff, and you need to figure out if you're going to be away for a day, drivable or not, come back home. If so, that's great. If you are traveling for a few more days, more than that, or a week or whatever, you have to make sure you're prepared for a long haul. So let's just make sure that you stay negative, stay safe out there, and let's get into it. Today, as you can see, I'm wearing black gloves. For some people, they may choose to wear gloves during the games. I'm thinking about it. Might be trying it out. I don't know. So here are some gloves that you can kind of picture what it looks like. And this is what it is. Okay. My husband's printing something. The dog woke up too. Like, what's going on? All right. So I'm also suggesting to bring an HDMI cord. In case you do get stuck in a certain location, weather's about to change, you could definitely hook it up to, oh, that's my son. Mike, you gonna come say hello? No? Yeah, you make a lot of noise with that printer. It's daddy? Oh, okay. HDMI cord, you might need an extension to where it will connector to your iPad. This is great if you're gonna try to watch movies and stuff like that in a hotel room or at home, anyway. Okay, moving on. Gloves, as we discussed. Thermometers. There is all different brands of thermometers. Definitely try to get yourself one to kind of just definitely check yourself maybe an hour or two before the game so that you know that you're ready to go. If you're not feeling good, it's great to have one of them inside your bag so that you can get right to it and know that you don't need to be leaving anywhere that you're leaving from if you do have a temperature above 100.3. So, other things I do have here is a disinfectant wand. They can get pricey, but if you want to get the good one, I suggest you probably put the money to it. This is great. You can utilize this on almost anything, and you can just wand it across things, and it's just gonna disinfect them, sanitize them. Right? So definitely try to purchase yourself one. And again, they need to be FDA approved. This one is supposed to be FDA approved. And pretty much you wind it over an area for like 5 to 10 seconds and it's supposed to disinfect the product. It could be, at this point, fruits. It could be anything that you come in contact with and you want to put it over it. I see nothing but 4.5 stars about it, so you never know. It does have a nice black light over it, but it doesn't, when you do scan it, it doesn't show that it like popping bacteria. So don't put that in your head thinking it's gonna show anything other than that. Okay, that one runs about $100. Black Friday's coming up, maybe it'll be half the price. So try to see if you can get some deals out of that. I also, purchased deodorizing wipes, Amazon, bathing wipes. You may be coming in some type of arena or gym that you can't shower after games because of this unforeseen measures that we're dealing with. So I suggest grabbing some wipes unless you're very local to the gym and or to the hotel, whatever it is that you're just leaving right out the gym and heading right to your hotel. You don't have to really worry about it. But if you're a type of person who needs to wipe up, why not? I suggest bringing this pack along so you can wipe your body, do the tea, and get it together. All right. I also have collapsible cups, bowls, measuring, you name it. I have it all. But these are some of the things that I did use when I was in the wubble over the WNBA summer season. And I used this, easy collapsible, easy to clean. You can use it anywhere. I also utilize this lovely, it's like a rice cooker slash make soup, heat up anything with liquids or make rice. This right here is worth all 20 bucks. Trust me, ask anybody who saw me during the wubble over the summer. I was making chicken soup, I was making rice, I was making pasta. I had it all. This right here, man, this is a lifesaver. So if you're in a hotel or in a location for a long time, I would strongly suggest to buy this. If you're a soup noodle type of person, you want to make it yourself, it's worth it. Yes, it does have a cord that plugs up to a outlet, so it's not like it's USB chargeable. This is also the measuring cups. I also had, ice maker, so I can make my own ice balls, measuring, collapsible measuring cups. You probably don't need all that, but I'm just suggesting if you're a measuring type of person. I kind of like to eye it, but you never know. And the little red things in here is actually drink covers. In case the fruit flies or something, try to get into it, you can cover your drink. Or if you're going to, probably not a bar right now, but if you're going to a place and you don't want to get roofied or anybody spitting your cup, there you go, right? You don't want no extra stuff flying around. So we have that. Over here, we have, I think I hit something, drawers, your own spoon to travel with, and then I have collapsible bowls. Also, portable strainer. All you do is put it and you hook it on the back side. Oops. Hook it on the back side and it comes with a suction cup. You put it to wherever you're at, a sink, and it strains your noodles. So I was able to strain my noodles over the summer, y'all. No sogginess. Here it is. I have a collapsible bowl and it has a cover. Again, Amazon has it all, y'all. This helped me as well. But this would definitely help if you're traveling for a period of time and you don't want to deal with certain things that, or you might buy groceries or whatever and try to contain it. Also, while traveling, you might need a nice little nap. Here's a nice pillow that I bought on Amazon. It's soft, oh, it's fantastic. I swear by this. And also, it's really, really small, so it's not like it's going to be, you know, taking up space. I hook it right onto my backpack that I travel to, and it's easy. I bought two types of coolers. This cooler I'm gonna bring in my bag this year, and it actually unfolds to be even bigger. And this is supposed to take care of hot or cold type of things, items, so it keeps it cool, keeps it warm, and it's collapsible, so that's great. That's what we need. I'm also going to be having this within my vehicle when I do have local games. You could put cans in here. I actually put two bottles of water in there, and it's like a cooler. So, oops. It's a cooler. So, it helps to keep it in the car. You never know when you get a little thirsty when on the road for a long time. I also had this forever. Never used it, but I may use it this year. Coat hangers, you never know what they may not have or have within locker rooms, so hangers are great to hang our jackets up and stuff like that so it can stay wrinkle-free. Speaking of wrinkle-free, if you know me, work with me, after you saw me with it, you probably bought one. So this is a steamer. This helps out steam everything. I hate ironing, and this is fantastic to use. Oh, let me take my head tie off of that. Fantastic to use, and I'm telling you, within seconds it heats up and it takes all the wrinkles out within seconds. I actually use my head tie as the trying to put everything together here, so just like that. So I like it. It was a good probably 20 bucks. Again, Amazon. It's very light to travel with. eBags, and it's very thin. Toiletry stuff. It's all in here. I also travel with Dude Wipes. These are biodegradable, plant source fibers, and it's flushable. So you want to be extra clean? There you go. The mirror, decent size. You can kind of stay it by itself. If you prop it up right, you collapse it, you can fold it. So mirror, definitely want to see the back of your head or whatever it is, great. I also bought this, which I have yet to use. It is actually a water bottle. So you would put it on, it's like it comes in a case. You'll put it on your travel bag, and then guess what? It's collapsible. So sure enough, you sit there, you open it, has a little spout. As soon as you flip that open, air comes out, and you can add water to it. You can also put it away, recollapse. Oops, get this right, get the air out of it, right? Collapsible, put it back in here. What you do is put it on to your bag and clip it, and you're good to go. So that if you're traveling in an airport or anything like that, and once you get in the airport and you want to fill it up, you don't want to deal with other things, you don't want to pay for a bottle of water. They have plenty of fountains within airports or anywhere else that you do, but you might be a little cautious because of this pandemic. So that's up to you if you want to travel with a travel collapsible water bottle. I travel with a 2 or 3 packs of Tide Pods with Bounce into a nice little condensed bag. And my lovely wish I was there right now, Bahamas coin bag, because you might have to do laundry on the road. So this are the must-haves that I need in my bag, and I hope it helps you in the future. If you feel that you have anything else that you think would help towards officials across the world, the country, feel free to add it. Put it in the description below. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe. See you next time, y'all.